Hello dear students, today let us start a new chapter, heat and its effects. This is chapter 5 and physics chapter. Let's see, there are different types of energy like light energy, sound energy, mechanical energy, heat energy, etc. One of them is heat energy. Today we are going to learn about heat energy. The experiments conducted by Count Rumford and James Prescott in the beginning of 19th century established that heat is a form of energy known as thermal energy. Many other forms of energy can be converted to heat energy, and heat energy can be converted to other forms of energy. For example, when you rub your hands together, mechanical energy gets converted to heat energy and your hands become warm due to the change from mechanical energy into heat energy. Your hands become warm. When fuel is burned, chemical energy stored in the fuel gets converted to heat energy. When some fuel like petrol or diesel is burned, chemical energy which is stored in them get converted to heat energy. The heat energy of burning petrol is converted to mechanical energy. Again, this heat energy, it is converted to mechanical energy in a cart. In an electric heater, electric energy is converted to heat energy. Electric heater convert electric energy into heat energy. In a powerhouse, heat energy of burning coal is converted to electrical energy. Powerhouse, coal is used to produce energy, electrical energy. Then heat energy of burning coal is converted to electrical energy. When a solid, liquid or a gas is heated, its molecules gain energy and starts moving faster. The more we heat the substance, the fast its molecules move. Heat energy is therefore the energy of movement of molecules. As you already know, solids, liquids, gases, all are made up of molecules, and the arrangement of molecules in them. Solid, when we are heating all these type of things, solid, liquid or gas, what happen? Its molecules gain energy and move fast. And the more we heat the substance, the faster the molecules move. If you heat more, it will move very fast, faster and faster. Heat energy is therefore the energy of movement of molecules. Hence, we can say that heat energy is the energy of movement of molecules. Now let's go to the topic, effects of heat, what heat can do. First one, heat causes increase in temperature. When we heat water, for example, when we heat water, its temperature rises. Heat causes increase in temperature. Then second point is, heat causes expansion. As the water heats up, its volume increases. When we heat water, solid or liquid, anything, we can see that its volume increases. That means heat causes expansion. Heat causes change of state. As the water boils, steam comes out of the water. Means liquid water, liquid state change into gaseous state. Change of state. There is a change of state. Water changes its state. Heat causes chemical changes. For example, drop some pieces of vegetables in boiling water. After the water has boiled for a few minutes, the vegetables become soft and the taste changes. So we can see that the vegetables become soft and the taste also, its taste also changes. That means some chemical change occurred. That is, the vegetables get cooked. So cooking is a chemical change. Cooking of vegetable is a chemical change. So we can say that heat causes chemical changes. Then last point, heat affects the living organisms. Heat affects living organisms. If the water is examined under a powerful microscope before and after boiling, it is found that many bacteria that were earlier present in the water have died. So many microorganisms are present in water, after boiling they died. We can see that they have died. So we can say that heat affects living organisms. Now, what is expansion? Already I told you heat causes expansion. Then what is expansion? When we heat a substance, the movement of its molecules increases. The molecules start moving faster. This increase this increases the average distance between the molecules. After heating, the distance between molecules increases. Therefore, the space occupied by the molecules, the space occupied by the already in previous case already the space occupied by molecules also increases. The molecules need more space to move faster. We say that, so that's why heat causes expansion. They need more space, so they expand. We can say that heat causes expansion. Now, what happens in solids? Expansion in solids. The molecules of a solid are firmly bound to each other. There is not much space between the molecules in solids. They are closely packed. When a solid is heated, the particles gain energy and start to vibrate faster and faster. They just vibrate only from at their place. They start vibrating. When they get more energy, they vibrate faster and faster. This causes them to take up more space. For that vibration, faster movement, they need more space. And the solid matter expands. For that, to get that more space, they expand. And the solid matter expands. If the heat continues to build, it may provide enough energy for the particles to break free from their strong attraction to one another, causing the solid to melt. If we continue heating, if we continue giving more energy, more and more energy, it may start the solid start melting to get more space for the fast movement. Different solids expand by different amounts for the same increase in temperature. If the temperature remains the same, different solids expand in different amount. Now let's see some example experiments. You can see here solids expands on heating. To prove solids expand on heating. Activity 1, you can see this activity is in your book also. You can read it and understand. I will explain this. Activity 1, take a ring and ball apparatus. Here you can see in the picture, you can see ring and ball apparatus. This is ring and ball apparatus. This is a common experiment to used to explain expansion in solids. Take a ring and ball apparatus. This apparatus consists of a metal ring and a metal ball. At normal temperatures, the ball just passes through the ring. If the temperature is normal, the ball can pass easily through the ring. Now heat the ball. In the second step, we are heating the ball. Now heat the ball and try to pass it through the ring. The second figure, you can see the ball does not pass through the ring because it expands. Cool the ball. The ball has expanded on heating, so it cannot pass through the ring. Cool the ball to normal temperature. Now cool the ball, remove the heat energy. It will pass through the ring again. So we can say that solids expand on heating. Because of that expansion, the second case, ball cannot pass through the ring. So this is a common experiment to show solids expand on heating. Next, another activity is also there. If this apparatus is not available, you can do the next another activity. Take a metal rod about 50 cm long. You can see a metal rod here, 50 cm long. Lay it horizontally on two wooden supports. Keep one of its end against a wall. One end against a wall. And rest the other end on a round pencil. Here a round pencil is here. Rest the other end is kept on a round pencil. Attach a paper pointer to the pencil. At the end of the pencil there is a paper pointer. Now heat the rod from here. You can see, you will notice that the paper pointer rotates to the right. After some time, after giving some heat, the metal rod expand, and it causes the movement of the pencil, and the pointer rotates to the right. The more you heat the rod, the more the pointer will turn to the right. If you give more heat, it will move more to the right. So these all activities shows that solids expand on heating. Now Expansion in liquids. Let's see how liquids expand. The molecules of a liquid are not so firmly bound to each other as in a solid. There is less attraction, force of attraction between molecules is less than in solid. So there is some space between molecules in a liquid. Therefore, on heating, their vibrations increase more than the vibrations of molecules of solids. They vibrate more than in the case of solids. The result is that liquids expand more than solid on heating. As a result, liquids expand more on heating. The amount of expansion is different in different liquids. As you already learned, in case of solids, expansion is different for different solids. Here also, expansion is different for different liquids. For the same increase in temperature, if we increase the temperature, temperature remains the same, then different solids expand, different liquids expand in different amount. So let's see an activity to show expansion in liquids. Here, fill a flask up to the brim with water, fully filled with water. Take a rubber cork with a hole in it and insert a narrow tube to the hole. You can see there is a cork fixed here on the mouth of the flask, you can see, and through the hole of the cork a tube is inserted. The liquid, fix the cork firmly in the mouth of the flask. Now fix the cork firmly, tightly. The liquid will rise a little in a tube. Because the liquid needs some space, you can see some liquid enter into the tube. Now we heat. Next figure, you can see heat energy is given. After some time, you can see the level of first mark the level of water in the glass tube here, and in the after heating, the water level increases. That means liquid expands on heating. It takes more space. It need more space, so it will fill the. Level of water in the tube. When the heat reaches the liquid, it expands and its level in the tube goes up. Cool the liquid to normal temperature, the level will go down again. If we cool it, if we remove the heat energy, you can see that it will come back to the previous position. Means water level goes down. So we can say that liquids expand on heating. Now expansion in gases. On heating a gas, the vibrations of its molecules increase. As in the case of solid and liquid, here also molecule increases. The space between molecules are very much in the gases. Average distance between molecules increases. So the average distance after giving heat, after getting energy, the average distance between the molecules increases more. So the expansion will be more in case of gases than in solids or liquids. So expansion is more in maximum. Expansion is maximum in gases. Thus the gases expand more than liquids and solids on being heated. Already there is space between molecules. After heating, the space more increases more. So that's why it will expand more than liquids and solids. So here also one example is here. You can see the same flask. Empty the flask you used in the previous activity. Fix the flask to a stand in an upside down position over a beaker of water. Experimental arrangement is given here. There is a beaker filled with water and the glass tube inside the water. Touches the water. Now the flask is empty so that the glass tube dips inside the water. Heat the flask at the top. We are giving heat energy here to the flask. As the air in the flask expands, it escapes out of the flask. What will happen? First, the flask will become hot and the air inside it will become hot. Air expands on heating and it will move through the glass tube and enters the water. You can see the bubbles here. Because of heating, air inside the flask get into the water. Then you can see the escaping of air through water bubbles in the form of air bubbles. Now cool the flask. This process stops, and you can see cool the flask. As the air in inside the flask contracts, the water rises to the. Now what happened after cooling, after removing the heat energy, wait for some time, the flask will become cool. You can see water rises because the air contracts, already expanded air contracts, and it the tube become vacant. That's why water enter to the tube. Water rises up the tube. This shows that gas-like air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. So we can say that gases expand on heating. Now, some cases in which expansion we can see, which is useful expand, useful. They are useful. Sometimes they cause problems also. Some examples are here: expansion around us. The expansion of solids can be put to use. Sometimes it is useful. The automatic fire alarm system uses the fact that different solids expand by different amounts of heating. This expansion of solid is used in this automatic fire alarm, which gives a automatic alarm at the time of fire. The alarm contains two metal strips. One of the iron, you can see in the picture, two metal strip. This is called bimetallic strip. One is made up of brass and the other is made up of iron. Brass expands more, but there is difference in amount of expansion. Brass expands more than iron. When there is a fire, the bimetallic strip become hot and the brass expand to the side of iron. It will expand like this. It will bend towards the iron. Brass expand more, so it will bend towards the iron, towards the skew here, and it will touch. After some time, they come in touch with the screw, and the circuit becomes complete. At the time, the bell starts ringing. What will happen if the circuit is complete? The bell starts ringing. This is an electric circuit. The bell starts ringing, and to give the alarm, it will ringing bell is the alarm. As the fire is put out, when the fire is put off, the strips get cooled. It will come back to the and straightens again. Bended bimetallic strip straightens again, and the circuit circuit break. Thus, switching of the alarm. This causes the switching of the alarm. It will stop. Alarm will stop. And this is useful to fire. Automatic fire alarm is very useful. So this is a use of expansion. Now, the metal caps on glass bottles, sometimes they are very tight, so we can use some hot water. We can pour some hot water on the metal cap. The metal cap expand on heating and loosens. We can open it easily. Tight cap, we can open it easily. However, at many places, expansion causes problems. Sometimes they may cause problems also. In summer, electric cables between two poles expand and sag. In winter, they contract and become taut. If cables are laid in summer, they must be left a little loose to allow for contraction during winter. If this is not done, they may break on contraction in winter. While fixing electric cables, we have to keep in mind that they must left a little loose for contraction and also for expansion. Otherwise, it will cause problems. Another example: the railway tracks over which trains run are made of iron. During summer, the iron expands. To allow this expansion, space has to be left between two sections of the rail tracks. You can see in the picture there are two parts here. There is a gap between them. The space is provided for expansion in summer. Expansion in summer to avoid accidents. If it is not, if the gap is not given, what will happen? If it is not done, expansion of the tracks can cause them to bend because of the both of them will expand and they cause them to bend. This can cause serious accidents. To avoid that, gap is left between railway tracks. Another example is given here. Similarly, steel bridges on one end is made to rest on rollers. one end of the steel bridge. This is a steel bridge. One end is made to rest on rollers, so that it can cause expansion. Means in summer it can cause expansion. It will provide space for expansion during summer. So these are some problems due to expansion. So that's all for this session. Let's see in the next part.